These windows are even original. Unfortunately, most of the windows were destroyed during the Second World War. There were big bombardments in Budapest. But these windows were saved from the bombardments. They took them out of their frames and hid them down in the cellar among sandbags. And this is how they were actually saved for the future. Now you can see them in the original material. Up on the ceiling, we have very beautiful frescoes. They were painted by Carol Dodds, the same artist who painted the huge fresco of the opera house as well. In the first painting, there is a column which is rising up in the wall,
What would the Hungary, thinking of the recent work of laws of Hungary, in a sense that I thought I had to have a coat of arms, this is a historical coat of arms of Hungary. It is supported by two angels, and they also have the holy crown on the top of this coat. And finally, we have this third painting, which is a symbolic allegorical picture. There is a lady standing in the middle. Her name is Hungaria, which means Hungary in Latin. And actually, she represents the country. She's the symbol of Hungary. At her feet, there are crowds of Hungarians happily celebrating and cheering, and they're waving their hands towards her, while symbolically, the people are happy for Hungary in this picture. All around the fresco, it's again neo-Renaissance hand-painted decoration that you can see, and that's true for most of the parliament, even on the corridors, the ceiling decorations and the windows decorations are neo-Renaissance style. We have two types of columns here. Let's talk about this brown one first. This is the grand, they have eight of these grand columns. Each of them weigh 4 tons and they are 6 meters high, very impressive ones. And they're presents actually from Sweden. We got them as a present from the Swedish king himself. And with that, it's a kind of exception because most of the materials that were built into the Parliament building were from Hungary, so the Swedish one is quite an exception. Anyway, we have these white columns as well. All the white columns, we have four white statues anyway. These statues represent medieval pages. The pages are holding something in their hands. They are holding the copies of the Hungarian crown jewels. And these are just the copies, but now we're going to see the real crown jewels. But it's in the Great Dome Hall. This is the area where we can't use our cameras. So when we leave the ceremony, can you please turn off your cameras and not use them while we are in the Dome Hall area? These pictures show some moments from the lives of medieval Hungarian kings.
statues for a moment. These statues are made of ceramics, specially burned clay, while the statues of the kings out in the dome are made of metal. Above the statues, you can see these gold spires, these turrets. Now, they are Gothic ornaments, they don't have any specific meaning. However, they are coated with real gold on the outside. Most of the ornaments, which are higher than 3 feet in height, has this thin layer of gold coating, not just on the surface, but if you add up all these thin layers, it becomes quite gold, about 41 kilograms. This was the amount of gold which is used to decorate the bottles. Finally, let's mention this carpet we are standing on. It is a handmade carpet, and it's quite a large one. It's 21 meters long and 7 meters wide. It is one of the largest handmade carpets you can find in Europe. And it was also manufactured according to the original traditional design, how the famous Persian carpets were also made. But it was produced in Hungary, just using the Persian technology. Okay, and now if you're ready here, now we're going to see the chamber of the opera house. So we are in the chamber of the former upper house. We have two chambers, as I mentioned, both of them look very similar. There are just little differences between the two, mainly concerning decoration elements. In both chambers, we have 400 seats downstairs. We have 386 members of parliament, who sit in 5 different parties. We have 2 parties which form the government coalition, and we have 3 parties in the opposition nowadays. There are elections every 4 years, but the next one is very close now, just about 2 or 3 weeks' time. It's on the 6th of April. Perhaps you saw some, you've seen already some posters around town. Okay, they are about these coming up elections. Now, when the MPs come in, first they need to find their own seat, because we have fixed seats here. And when they find their seat, okay, they turn these tables over. And then you can see a digital display here with 4 buttons. This is part of the computerized voting system. The first 3 buttons are used for voting. Yes, no, and abstain. And when the vote is done, you can see the results immediately on those 2 boards up on the left side.
We also have a fourth button. This is for talking, okay? That is what you push if you want to say something. And then you stand up, and from these compartments, you take out the microphone, you attach it up in your chest, and you can stand up and make your speech on the spot. Everyone's gonna hear you quite nicely. However, you can also make use of that nice wooden platform there in the front. It is the speaker's platform. This is where the more important speeches can be performed from, and also where the head of the parliament, the speaker that I mentioned, is sitting on the top, and he's the one who conducts the sessions and keeps order in the room. Behind him, we have some coats of arms again. The middle one with the Holy Crown on is the historical coats of arms of Hungary. And we have six other shields there, which represent the most important royal dynasties which ruled here in the past 1,000 years. And then we have two paintings on the two sides. To the left, there is a scene from the 13th century. The king who's sitting there is called Andrew II, and he is now depicting issuing the very first constitution of Hungary, which was very similar to the English Magna Carta. Only came out 7 years after the English Magna Carta, and they had very similar contents, although they did not know about each other, obviously. And at this time of the history, it was only England and Hungary who had written constitutions, so it was a very modern thing to have. Then, on the other side, we have a scene from the 18th century. A young woman there is Maria Theresa again. Here she's talking to the Hungarian nobility. She's asking for some support, and she's getting that this is the happy moment when they come to an agreement. In the very middle, where you can see those red tables, the most inner circle of tables, you see they are different. Even the chairs we have, which are behind those red tables, are different. They are a bit bigger and a bit more comfortable. Well, this is where the government is seated, okay? The prime minister and his cabinet can take a seat there. And at the back, where you are standing, in the side balconies, this is where the media is represented, the journalists and the press. Also, we have some TV cameras installed, and all the sessions are broadcast by the TV. We also have the normal, ordinary Hungarian citizens coming in sometimes. It is their right to do so. They have to register first, but then they can come in and take part in the sessions. Go down here, but up on the balconies. They have about 150 seats reserved for this reason on the upper balconies. And finally, please take a look at this beautiful ceiling up there. It is a neo-Renaissance style ceiling, very special in my opinion. It's a wooden carved inlaid one. And it is carved of a very good quality wood, it is Slavonian oak. Most of the wooden furniture around us is from this wood, this Slavonian oak. And well, not the ceiling or the platform, but the rest was produced here in the parliament itself. We have a big carpenter's workshop down in the basement. It even operates nowadays, and this is where they repair all the furniture. Otherwise, the parliament meets every Mondays and Tuesdays, sometimes another day maybe as well. And most of the time it is the spring and the autumn when the parliament is together. During the winter and during the summer, there is a long vacation for them. Right, if you have any questions, you can still ask me, but let's do it out on the corridor, okay? Let's continue from there. So you're welcome to find me with questions on the corridor. See you out there. And now we are
area, the smoking area, this used to be the place where the MPs moved. Okay, it was not allowed to smoke inside the session hall, so the MPs had to come out to these neighboring foyers to smoke their cigars. But you know, cigars take a longer time to smoke, and you need a good place to store them. So you have some nicely established cigar holders here with these windows. Something is funny about them, you can see some numbers on that. So maybe half of the numbers, you can see how to find a way around the cigars.
Thank you.
Chief Minister.
Those seats you've got.
Yeah, I still see how to make that for
Thank you.